morning, you guys. Today is... what day is today? Tuesday. Sorry for the mess behind me. If it looks a little bit different, it's because I'm reorganizing Natalie's room. But this morning I woke up with a massive headache and I'm feeling like in the back of my head, just here, I have like this big of a lump here. You want to come and say hello to our friends? And I don't know, I'm just feeling really, really sore and a really big
mommy,
headache.
Mommy, sit on this floor.
So fun. Mommy quiere poner ropa. Vamos a jugar con Melissa?
Oh, Melissa.
Yeah? ¿Quieres jugar con tu amiga?
Mommy, yes.
Yeah, do you want to play with your friend? And I think I might go to the emergency to just have it checked out. See? You want to read the story? Okay. Because this is not normal and I feel a little bit stressed out. I don't know if I said that. When something is related to your head or your brain or something like that, you can't help but get a little crazy. And clean. You cannot... Are you on to vlog? No toques. Aquí. Aquí. So, shake. Okay. Can you say hello?
Hi, girl.
Hello.
Hello.
Cuidado. Thank you. That's so good.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're natural.
Your mama?
Yeah. Mama? Okay. I don't know what she touched
Natalina?
Now.
Natalina?
Natalie?
No.
Natalina? Yes, I think that my friend is going to drive me. Natalie? To the emergency room. But it's a little bit funny. Not funny. Because I just recorded Caesar last night or two nights ago giving me my injections and I wanted to include that footage in my in my vlog because it's part of my life right now, taking the injections when I have because of my urticaria. Okay, momentito. And I wanted to share that with you guys. But now waking up with this, I start to feel like, what the heck is going on with me? What's wrong with me? Am I sick? Am I not sick? Am I stressed? What's happening? In one moment, I thought I woke up with this pain because maybe Caesar rolled over and smacked me in the back of the head with his watch or something.
School.
But I suppose that if that was true, I would have woken up.
Look but it.
No.
Mommy, is it?
Is it? Okay.
Mommy, is it?
And, yeah. I don't know what more to say about that. I see you all blurry now. What do you want to play?
Mila.
Yeah, so we are here playing a little bit now and I'm gonna prepare our things to go. And Natalie's clothes and my clothes, but oh my god, I feel like the biggest pain in my neck. What do you miss? Ah, the puerta. No, it's not broken. Yeah, we can put it back. I have the biggest pain here. That's scary. I don't want to be sick. I hope I just have slept funny. But it's so weird. And I have been experiencing... Okay. I have been experiencing severe headaches for the past few weeks, so... That's why I'm stressing myself out a little bit.
Come here.
Mira, voy a... Mama, yeah. You okay? Where's she going?
Que bien.
Que bien. Can you say thank you? Thank you.
Thank you.
Maybe we'll take the girls out for an ice cream or something as well after the doctor's appointment. We'll see. Yeah. What do you want to wear today? What clothes do you want to have? You want to have jeans or shorts? It's gonna rain today, I think. It's looking a little bit cloudy outside. Wow. It's a little windy. Margot, ¿te gusta? ¿Rico? ¿Para el fuego? ¿Dónde? I'm not dying, but I'm not feeling good. And Caesar is kind enough to let me have maybe an hour or something for myself. He told me that he was gonna take Natalie and go with her to the soft play and go to the pharmacy and pick up my medicine, because when I went to the doctors, she took a look at me, she listened to what I had to say, and she said that I'm suffering from like inflammation in my neck from being tense and stressed. So she was touching my head where I have the the swollen area, and she said that this is connected to the neck obviously, and she said that she could feel that I was full of like knots. I don't know the technical term in English, but I had like an inflammation all the way from my shoulder up in my neck, and now it was to the point where it was reaching the connection to my back head, and this part is now really, really inflamed and swollen. So that's the pain I'm feeling. So she prescribed me two different medicines, one anti-inflammatory one and one for the pain. And I'm gonna take that each one once a day for 10 days. So that's the plan. And right now I'm just in my pajamas, or half in my pajamas, in bed, and I'm gonna try to relax. I have my computer with me to watch some shows, and I'm also gonna put this on myself. It's a heat lotion and a MSM kind of gel to see if that can help take down a little of the tenseness. I don't know how to say, but yeah, so that was my day today. We went to the doctors, we had an ice cream with the girls and let them run around in the area where they have the mini golf on top of the building where I work. And after I came home, we took lunch, Natalie had her siesta or her nap, and I tried to take a nap as well. But I couldn't, because when I put my head on the pillow, it's pressing on my area where I'm swollen and I'm not able to relax, so I couldn't sleep. So Caesar just said, okay, so stay home, I will take her for a while and hopefully you can relax a little. If you can sleep, good, if not, just try to relax. So that's the plan. I'm gonna eat an ice cream, I'm gonna watch a show, and then hopefully get started on editing this vlog. But if not, I will do that later. But yeah, I'm also gonna rewind in this video to show you the other day when we were dealing with my injections, because I feel like my health is a big topic at the moment. So yes, I have had people asking me regarding my urticaria, how I'm doing, because I'm not talking about it at the moment so much. I used to update a lot over on my Instagram. Every time I would have my symptoms, basically I would share a picture because it's so severe and I was feeling so frustrated with that. And at the moment, because I'm taking the injections and eating the medicine, I don't have any physical symptoms. But if I don't take it, they return. And that's why it's chronic. I don't know how long I will have to be on my treatment, but I'm hoping that no more than half year more, we'll see. But that was something I was scared of this morning when I woke up. Maybe it was like a bad reaction to the medicine or something. Because we just took it the other day. So I think I'm sensitive to medicine and I don't like to take medicine. So, you know, my brain is like making up reasons why I could be feeling this way. But anyway, that's all I have to say right now. But thank you so much for watching. And I know also some of you were requesting more vlogs on my channel. But to be honest, my goal at the moment is to grow my channel, because I love doing YouTube, and if you have been following me from the beginning, I have been doing it now for a few years, and I still am under the 1000 subscriber mark, which is my goal, because this is the point where you can maybe start to make a little bit of money by doing YouTube, because basically it's a job and it takes a lot of effort and time from me to produce this content for you guys. So if I don't have X amount of subscribers, I'm doing it for free. And although I've had opportunity to make money through YouTube, but not thanks to YouTube itself, they have a limit. And I think that it's good that they have this limit, because when I started out, they didn't. But anyway, long story short, I'm concentrating on building my platform, building my subscriber base to be able to also give you other kinds of content, because I love to vlog. It's my favorite video to make, but nobody searches for vlogs these days. So if you want to have more people coming to your channel and finding you, you need to make searchable videos. And in my case, if I just do a day in the life and whatever I want to call it, nobody's gonna find that video if they are not already subscribed. But if I do, for example, a cleaning video, they can find it. And thanks to my cleaning videos, I'm getting more and more attention. And last video I posted on Friday, today is Tuesday, has already over 500 views. And for me, that's good. I've had a few videos that have had more than 1,000 views, but not in this short amount of time. So little by little, I see an increase in my subscribers count, and also the interest people are showing in my other videos thanks to my cleaning videos. So, and because I'm a mom, and because it's a very big part of my day, everyday life is cleaning, I like to share that with you as well. I like to watch cleaning videos, and it's like keeping me motivated to have my house or my home clean. And I hate to clean, as you probably know by now. I really, really hate to clean, but doing it with you guys gives me motivation, if you understand what I'm trying to say. I'm doing it to motivate you, but you are motivating me to keep doing it, to keep cleaning, to keep producing content for you by watching and interacting with me. So, and I'm making a lot of friendships through this community, and I'm just so thankful for every single one of you. And honestly, I feel like you're a part of my life, and I don't want this relationship to finish. And I want to be able to keep on doing YouTube. I want to be on this platform. So I need to grow my channel, and that's why I'm not doing only my vlogs, because I need more subscribers. So if you want to help me out, you can share my videos, for example, on a social media platform. You can subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and like the video and subscribe, because all of that helped me with the algorithm to push my video out. So if you would like to help me reach my goal, please do that things for me, and I can continue to make content for you. So I will see you guys very soon. I love you so much. Be safe, and I talk to you guys later. Bye. Of course, this is disgusting. Do you remember how to do it? Biochemical waste. Pero no hace. You have to. Don't push it now.
Yeah.
But you have to remove this part.
Remove it?
No. You have to take out.
Yeah, hombre.
But you're dirty.
¿Cómo que dirty?
You have things there.
Quiero esto ya, pero ¿qué es lo que tiene que quedar para arriba? ¿Esto? ¿Había algo que quedaba para arriba?
No, arriba no. What you have to do is, when you have taken out this part,
sí,
you have to put four fingers in right here,
yeah,
to find the place. You have to take the meat.
Sí, yeah. And sí, pero había una parte.
And then you have to slowly push it in, and when everything is in, you let go, and it's gonna go back by itself.
Sí, pero había una cosa de esto que tenía que dar esto para arriba. Hay una parte de la jeringuilla que tiene que dar hacia arriba.
I suppose this or this for you to see it. If you have it this way, maybe you cannot see it.
Oh, maybe será.
It's not funny.
No grabes esto, por Dios.
You don't like to do it. I don't like to do it. But we have to do it.
Venga. ¿Cuál brazo primero?
This one you took the last time and it hurt less.
Vale. Como cuatro dedos del codo.
Sí.
Y tengo que correr aquí.
Uh-huh.
Así.
But I felt like you were more in this area. Okay. When okay. You did it here, I felt like it was more painful. It was like more near to the bone. So here it's like more meat.
Okay.
So I think you should do from back. I think. Yeah, I think so.
Aquí. Otro dedo. Aquí.
Yeah, like there, maybe.
Quítale el agua.
No, no.
Venga.
You have to quitar. Yo no puedo quitar. Relax. Please relax. Okay, move away a little. I'm not ready.
¿Qué?
I'm not ready. I'm not ready. No. I'm not ready. I don't like this. Okay. I'm gonna put you here. But you're gonna be in my video, like, naked. Please don't do anything nasty.
Y no, tiene un tipo de peso.
It's too big to put here.
¿Eh?
It's too big to put here. No. Okay. Stop. No. Okay, the medicine is coming out. Can you concentrate, please?
Vamos a ver, cuatro deditos, ¿no? Sí, sí.
Do you know what you're doing?
Sí, claro.
Mira. We didn't wash this. We haven't cleaned it yet.
Oh, Dios. Está muy mal.
Have you washed your hands?
No.
Because you are touching my arm and I...
Toma, coge.
Sorry.
Sí, es que es más tonto.
¿Por qué?
Porque están montando ahí un tinglado con una cosa que hay que
hacer. Ah, mira, aquí es el...
Hay que hacerlo rápido esto, ya está. ¿Sabes? Me está poniendo a mí nervioso, ya se me están quitando las ganas de hacerlo.
¿Ganas que hacerlo?
Sí, sí, sí.
Okay.
A ver. ¿Qué es lo que has visto aquí?
You can see, like, the point of it. I don't know if that's what you meant. Do you want this up arriba?
No lo sé, yo estaba preguntando que ella...
Mira, porque dijo... aquí puedo ver... Here is like sharp in that end. Can you see that it's sharp there? More sharp than the other.
Yo creo que es así.
Mm-hmm.
Es así, hay que meterlo así. Y después presionar, ¿no?
Yeah.
No,
okay. I need to.
¿Tú qué?
Be ready.
Ya, pero es que esa posición ya es rara para pincharte yo. Deberías estar más cómoda, más.
Mm-hmm. But it's because I'm nervous, I'm scared.
¿Qué más para aquí que para aquí, no?
I think I wanted.
Aquí.
Like, yeah. Like if you put.
Aquí.
Okay, wait, okay, okay. Wait.
Okay?
Mm, espera.
Vale. ¿Puedes ya?
Yeah.
¿Sí?
Mm, I need to relax now.
Tranquilo.
But squeeze my skin more.
Mm. ¿Así?
Mm.
Yeah.
Ow.
Ya, despacito, ya va para adentro. Va.
Slowly. It's okay, it's not hurting, it's just uncomfortable.
No se retrotrajo esto.
Maybe because we were not so fast.
No sé. Lo he puesto todo.
Okay.
Muévete, sóbate el brazo para que se mueva. Para que se remueva así.
Yeah,
esto hay que meterlo en algún lado, ¿no? Ahí.
Sí, en la. ¿But all the medicine in? ¿You're sure?
Sí, sí. Seguro.
¿Has visto? I have cleaned both of them. have to
measure.
Cuatro
dedos del codo.
No. Meta, wait.
Coge más con. Okay, I try. Cuatro dedos. Yo no sé si lo hice con eso para arriba o no. Yo que sé, no grabé ya, deja de grabar.
Es ok,
no. Ponte una tirita o algo, yo no quiero estar.
Es
ok. Oh, yes.
Nice, thank
sí, super nice. No.
But I think I'm kind of brave for somebody that doesn't like needles. I hate needles. Everybody that knows me knows that I hate needles. So this is what we're doing now, instead of going to the hospital. Sister is doing it at home. We should have done it like 5 days ago, but we hate it so much, so we don't want to do it. Directly after he puts the injections, I start to feel like a metallic taste in my mouth, and I feel like my arms are sleeping, and I feel like I want to sleep. I get really, really tired, and I don't know, I think it's because of the medicine, but also because of the like the mental effort that it takes, because I hate needles and he hates to do it, and it's like very stressful for us. But now I have that really, really bad taste in my mouth, like metallic, and yeah, I feel like lazy in my body. And but it's strange, because when I get the medicine I feel like I can relax, I feel like it's doing something positive, because when I'm not taking it I feel like anxious, and I feel like I'm scared that the symptoms are gonna come back and that kind of thing. But in the moment I'm getting it, it's not nice. It's not nice. I don't know for how much more I will have to do it. We will see.